Samat Busby. And both teams were presented to Samat, a man who played in a cup final 49 years ago. After the presentations, the national anthem.
Of Graham Souness. In fact, Liverpool decided to go to that end, behind which goal their supporters are ranked, and Spurs go to the other end. Well, what an afternoon it's going to be for Ray Clements, so many times at Wembley. Now the first time he's faced Liverpool since he left Anfield. So the Spurs side with Ray Clements in goal, Chris Hughton number two, Paul Miller at three, Paul Price at four, Mike Hazard at five, Steve Perryman, the captain, at six, who played here in the 71 and 73 finals, both with Spurs, both won. Seven, Osvaldo Ardiles, eight, Steve Archibald, nine, Tony Galvin, 10, Glenn Hoddle, 11, Garth Brooks, and number 12, the substitute, Ricky Villa. For Liverpool, Bruce Grobbelaar in goal, number two, Phil Neal, three is Mark Lawrenson, four, Alan Kennedy, five, Ronnie Whelan, and six, Phil Thompson, seven, Kenny Dalglish, eight, Sammy Lee, nine, Ian Rush, who's having a tremendous season with his 22 goals, 10 is Terry McDermott, and 11, Graham Souness, with the substitute, David Johnson. Well, Phil Thompson, out of the Liverpool side since January, first with injury, and then he just couldn't force his way back into a successful team, and is now in because of the injury to Alan Hansen. Mike Hazard, such a revelation for Spurs this season. Heard only yesterday that he'd be playing in place of Villa. In fact, his whole family has come down by minibus from the northeast, except his mother, apparently. She's never seen him play. Glenn Hoddle, well, he's had back trouble all week. An injury sustained in the FA Cup tie at Chelsea last Saturday. He hasn't trained all week, in point of fact, but passed himself fit yesterday. And the two captains tossing up are certainly old friends. Steve Perryman of Tottenham on the right and Graham Souness. They were both in the same Spurs youth side in 1970 that won the FA Youth Cup. And then Graham Souness moved on to Middlesbrough and then to Liverpool. Record receipts here at Wembley today, £730,000. So Spurs in white, attacking the goal to our left, get the 1982 Football League Cup final underway against a Liverpool side wearing that familiar all-red strip. Both sides in such devastating and red-hot form at the moment. Spurs unbeaten in their last 16. Liverpool, who've won four of their last five and are holders of this trophy. Spurs, who've got to this final without so much as conceding a goal, the first team to do that. Brooks caught offside. It's a free kick to Liverpool. Slight confusion as to where it should be taken from. And Phil Thompson is the man who'll take it. How fortunate Liverpool are to have a man of his calibre to step in for Alan Hansen. Kennedy, Thompson, long ball forward chasing towards McDermott, who turns it in towards Dalglish. Ardiles is back for Tottenham, holds off that challenge from Dalglish, which referee Willis deemed to be unfair, giving Spurs the free kick. On his way, but they get a corner, and it was a sloppy piece of play there by the Spurs number three, Paul Miller, oblivious of the fact that Rush was in behind him. be Dalglish with a corner. Ronnie Whelan's up in the box, making a run towards the near post. In fact, got the header in. Wasn't far away either, and Spurs simply failed to pick him up and could have paid the highest price. Thompson, Neil. Neil again, Dalglish, Souness, good bit of play here by Liverpool, putting a few passes together well. And it must have been Rush backing in on Miller that caused that free kick. Now Holt, we haven't really seen him yet, but that's a pass that is played too firmly forward, and Grobbelaar, with all the time in the world, plays it safely into touch. And now it's Mark Lawrenson for Liverpool. Oh, hits it straight at Ardiles, but followed through quickly before Ardiles had a chance to bring it under control. A slip by Perryman, but he readjusted quickly enough, and Hoddle tries to get Archibald through behind the Liverpool defence. Archibald all the way! Spurs in the lead, 11 minutes gone. A clumsy sort of goal, but Archibald's persistence paid off. The bounce really went his way. Played there. Lawrenson, it bounced back off Archibald. Suddenly he was through, and just a little nick with the outside of his right boot as Grobbelaar came out. And Spurs go into the lead. Their first attack, and it produces a goal. Steve Archibald, who was their top scorer last season, has had a lot of trouble with an injury, an ankle injury this season, has come back to the biggest stage and has given Spurs the start they want. Referee giving every chance to this game, I must say. The linesman was flagging there, but he played a good advantage, and how well it was taken advantage of there by Hazard until he finally puts the ball into the path of Rush. And now Liverpool with Wheeler. A sign of tremendous competitors. You can be sure their heads will never drop in spite of this early setback. But Spurs now coming forward again with Ardiles. Steve Archibald was superb. It was a clumsy sort of build-up, and he took his luck well, but the last little flick past the keeper was absolute perfection. Miller. Long ball towards Garth Crooks. Both he and Hazard have gone for it. It was won quite easily by Thompson, who got in a good defensive header there, and it sets Liverpool on their way again. Dalglish twisting and turning, finding Souness, who looks to be in quite commanding form in the midfield for Liverpool this afternoon. Neil finding McDermott. Neil again, time to cross it in. That's Dalglish. Oh, a lovely piece of play by Dalglish! And saved on the line by Clements when Sammy Lee went in. And Liverpool, a knock on the leg for a former teammate, but Liverpool came so close to getting the equaliser there, and it would have been made by a marvellous piece of play by Kenny Dalglish. There's Dalglish with a lovely chip. Lee with the header, and Clements eventually saving. Hoddle. Oh, he twisted Whelan well there. There's the pass towards Archibald again, and that was very nearly a very profitable thrust by Spurs out of nothing. A pass by Hoddle and a header by Archibald. Here at Liverpool again, the 1982 League Cup final really beginning to warm up now. Probably needed that early goal to get the appetite of both sides going completely. And it was Archibald who gave Spurs that lead. And now Souness. It's a good ball there for McDermott. Played in first time, it should be Clements's. And the little throw out for Ardiles. Hazard, a touch which Galvin struggled to get to. chance of trying to make amends, supported this time by Ardiles and Hollow, and it's Galvin who's down injured. Hollow goes on. Now it's with Crooks. Free kick to Tottenham. And Galvin's in trouble. He got to his feet, collapsed on the ground again, and clearly is in need of attention. Ray Clements bending over him. And a look of concern from the Tottenham manager. It was a collision he had with Graham Souness, number 11 going in on it there. Well, two men going for the ball. And it looks as though Galvin is going to try and hobble on with a go. Now, where were we? Yes, a free kick for Tottenham on the far side to be taken by Hoddle. Curled in award towards Crooks. Ardiles. And Hoddle again. Perryman playing it back to Price, and it might well go back all the way to Price. And Tony Galvin looks to be moving fairly easily. Whose pass in turn finds Neil. Oh, and the slippery top is catching one or two of them out, but Dalglish looks sure-footed enough. Ardiles trying to get back there, and in the end, Ardiles holds him off. Then Lee gets in, Hazard. Oh, and this could be trouble. Sammy Lee is in there. Oh, and a miss by Rush. Well, that was an incredible miss by Ian Rush for Liverpool after a mistake by Mike Hazard had suddenly put Liverpool in. Hazard was dispossessed, Dalglish was on him, the ball then eventually went right across that six-yard area, and somehow Rush just failed to turn it in. Now McDermott. Liverpool give the impression of being like a really coiled spring who are just waiting to come out and punish the opposition. Seems to be so much power in their play at the moment, they just can't get the finishing touch to it. And they are this goal down. Here's Lawrenson. And now Dalglish. And a powerful header by Souness. But it's wide. It's going to be a Tottenham throw. Ardiles, Hoddle, Rush. And Price there, hitting the ball against Lee. Rush keeping it in play. And the half-time whistle goes with Spurs a goal into the lead. Scored by Steve Archibald, and if anything, a little bit against the run of the play in the first half, where Liverpool have had the better of it, but as yet have not really been able to put a finishing touch in the Spurs penalty area. Certainly Ian Rush had a chance with the ball in the six-yard area, but that went flying away across the turf. And so Bob Paisley and the men on the Liverpool bench have some work to do in the next 10 minutes. To try and put a few things right in the second half. So the half-time score here at Wembley in the 1982 Football League Cup final, it's Liverpool 0, Spurs 1. So Spurs leading by a goal to nil as we welcome you back to Wembley for the second half of the 1982 League Cup final, the 22nd League Cup final in point of fact, and the 16th held at Wembley. Kennedy giving Liverpool a free kick in the opening seconds. Both sides, in fact, appearing in their third League Cup final. Spurs have won on their two previous visits here. Liverpool have won one and have lost one. Whelan, Lee, Kennedy towards Dalglish, who got the header in. And Ardila is gently finding his skipper, Steve Perriman, with that pass going straight to Souness. Bit of backpedalling necessary from Alan Kennedy, but a pass that picks up Neil. And now for Lawrenson. Dalglish heading it again, and Price getting it away. Liverpool superior for so much of the first half, but failing, which is unlike them, to put things together where it really matters inside the penalty area. Dalglish, in point of fact, having the first half where his touch really seemed, for the most part, to desert him. Kennedy. Having said that, Dalglish also. Beautiful opening that Ian Rush failed to turn in. But here's Lawrence. And now Dalglish. Versus Archibald. Here's Kennedy. Miller backpedaling, could only head the ball to Dalglish, who turns it on to McDermott under the volley, maybe, and pushed away well by Ray Clements. Just a fleeting mistake there in the Tottenham defence. Clements saved well, and caught one. Well, it was a lovely little ball there, played by McDermott, by Dalglish rather, and McDermott hitting it on the half volley. There was the save. Ardiles. Brooks. Now can Ardiles get the return? A little bit of support from Houghton on that touchline. What's happened? The ball's still in play, and it's snowy. Antwin was saying a throw, and the referee also. Well, in the end of it all, Rush is on the ball for Liverpool. Now Dalglish struck well, but struck straight at Clements. Ray Clements, and at the other end of the field, the man who replaced him at Anfield, Bruce Grobbelaar. Well, that will find Rush. Hazard, oh, and he's run straight in to Lee, and Lee in turn gets it away to McDermott. Dalglish very active up front. Now this could be dangerous because Dalglish on the turn and the shot again straight at Clements. And again Kenny Dalglish a little displeased with himself for not hitting that ball more firmly. Because this is always a danger sign when he's in this position. He wriggles himself clear but didn't really hit it firmly enough. Lee. That's a good ball by Lee, spraying it wide to the right as he finds Neil, and now McDermott. Again, Dalglish getting in that dangerous position, looking, and no penalty. The referee in Liverpool were looking hard at the referee, but Kenny Dalglish, look at that expression there that suggests that he feels he should have had a penalty there against Paul Price. He's looking hard at the linesman. Neither of the officials wanted to know. Terribly difficult for Price, but he certainly seems to be hanging on to Dalglish there. And Dalglish quickly on his feet appeal. Meanwhile, the substitution has been made, and the cup final hero of last season is on, Ricky Villa, and young Mike Hazard, who contributed a fair bit for Spurs, in fairness to him, goes off. And now we wonder whether Spurs can hold on for another 25 minutes with Ricky Villa now in their side. Getting a first touch there, chest trap, being chased by Souness, beaten by Lee, who also beats Ardiles, and here's McDermott, and in turn it's with Alan Kennedy. Whelan is right up there with a header back for Rush. And Rush again, into the side netting, goal kick. Kenny Dalglish in the end got hold of the ball and put the ball into the net, but the whistle had gone, it's a goal kick. Back here, and Hubble can pick it up. Finding Crooks, Hubble flattened, Galvin finding Villa again. Want to whack it to the far side and pick up Cooper. Can he find a cross? Well, it was pulled back behind Archibald, and Liverpool can take it up again. A shove in the back, spotted by the linesman and the referee on Kenny Dalglish, giving Liverpool the free kick. They're going to make a substitution now, and Terry McDermott is coming off. McDermott off, kicking the ball away. In fact, Terry McDermott there, too happy with that decision, obviously. And it's David Johnson who's on. Dalglish ducking in there, but here's Ardiles again. And this one will come for another Tottenham throw. Time is desperate for him now. Look at the anxious faces and the squirming backsides on that bench. Here's Hubble. Now Hubble, great save, and a chance for Archibald, knocked away by Souness. Great shot by Hubble. Knocked away by Brobbelaar. In goes Archibald, and Souness, to the agony of Spurs, gets it away. Galvin getting a cross in. Thompson away, Dalglish right back, in spite of the attentions of Ardiles, still finds his man, and here's Rush, played inside again for Whelan, the two youngsters in this Liverpool side, finding Johnson on the far side, the substitute, who's hardly had a touch since he came on. Dalglish couldn't get to it, but he might get to this. Villa going in there, using his shoulder, Johnson playing it in, Whelan! Here's Hubble. Maybe it's not over yet as Crooks gets in there with the header. Grobbelaar under pressure from Archibald. Oh, and Miller went flying in there, but the whistle had gone. So near to taking it, Ray Clements against his old teammates. So near the end, he has to pick the ball out of the net. Pitch back by Miller. Now Cody. Now Beer. Hoddle. Perriman again. Ardiles. Oh, another fall for Lee. The shouts of the Liverpool fans behind that Tottenham goal are beckoning those red shirts forward. But not quite as far forward as that, and Price can cut that one out. 1 minute of time added on, and that's the end of the 90 minutes. And so we have extra time as the managers come on. You can see Keith Birkinshaw in the middle there in the Fawn overcoat. And look at the joy for a moment there on the Liverpool bench, as their backroom staff know that maybe all the pressure was in the end. They got the deserved reward, an equaliser, and now it's a question of the managers persuading their men that the battle can be won. And Bob Paisley saying, come on your feet. Come on. Well, that's how we stand as we go into extra time, and the crowd are certainly getting more than their money's worth now. So Spurs get us away at the start of the first period of extra time, 15 minutes each way. Ronnie Whelan, his first appearance at Wembley, and his goal makes this extra time a necessity. Now who will have the fresher legs? Well, Rush looks sprightly enough for Liverpool. Houghton hammering it away, but slightly miscuing. Here's Neil feeding Lee, but it wasn't an easy ball for Sammy Lee, in fairness to him. And it's a goal kick for Tottenham. And blood on the side of Mark Lawrenson's face. Now Souness. To Lee. Oh, what a good ball in for Dalglish! In behind that Spurs defence so well, a very, very difficult ball to take on the volley, hit in with good weight, in fact, by Sammy Lee, and suddenly there was Dalglish, and they have to be hit perfectly to register. Ardiles. Ricky Villa. Still with Villa. Well, it was at that end in the FA Cup final when he scored the goal that finally finished off Manchester City. And it was a fair run across the face of the goal there. Liverpool forcing him away. He didn't really get a clear sight on goal. Grobbelaar went diving, but it was always safe for him. He. Souness. Thompson. Played nearly 16 minutes of this first period of extra time, but it's up now. I notice that Ronnie Moran is coming onto the bench, but I don't think people will be allowed on. I think it's just surely a straight turnaround now. Keith Birkinshaw wondering if he's going to be allowed on, which he is. And Ronnie Moran, in fact, looking to the eye wound or the head wound that Mark Lawrenson has got. We saw the blood of it earlier. And we're left with 15 minutes here at Wembley for the 1982 League Cup final. 1-1 the score. 15 minutes now of extra time remaining. Neil. Sonis. Dalglish. It's a good cross, and Rush was almost in there. He was at Olympic sprinter's pace there, just for 3 or 4 yards. But couldn't quite keep hold of it. Archibald. Martinez. And now Crooks. Pushed away beautifully by Godwin. First real strike on goal I think we've seen from Garth Crooks today. And he hit it well, and Grobbelaar reacted superbly. Tottenham's corner, Tony Galvin with it, playing it for Villa. And now for Archibald, but here's Whelan. Seems to be everywhere, that young man at the moment. And his pass finds Ian Rush. Now Houghton is there a fraction before Sammy Lee. Good pass by Hobble, finding Perriman again, but Liverpool's throw. Whelan ducking there to get it to Kennedy, trying in turn to put Dalglish in behind them. Well, that was Ardila's mistake, and it's Rush. And now it's Dalglish. He's onside. Is this the decisive moment? It's played for Whelan, and he's done it again. It's astonishing, the first time he's ever played at Wembley, and he's got two of the goals. Ronnie Whelan. So Spurs, after holding a lead until 3 minutes from the end of normal time, are now in desperate danger of losing the League Cup final. So Ardila's mistake is pounced on. Dalglish now just onside, looks up, plays it back for Whelan, who was begging for it at that point, into the roof of the net. Liverpool 2, Tottenham Hotspur 1. Spurs have never lost at Wembley, and they've gone 25 games without losing a cup tie. But those records now are in dire danger against Liverpool. But wait a moment, here's Brooks, no, and a goal kick. About 8 minutes remaining. Spurs fans have gone silent after so much jubilation through the afternoon, but that's just a babble of noise there. The Liverpool fans down from the northwest. Liverpool almost there. And here's Whelan, the man who has put them in the driving seat with those two goals, one right at the end of normal time and then this precious one in extra time. Souness trying to get in there, but Miller getting it back. A minute remaining. Villa. It's got to be something pretty dramatic now. And who knows, perhaps Spurs can yet pull out something pretty dramatic as Villa. No, it falls for Sammy Lee. And what about that for a ball? Inviting Ian Rush to make a charge, to take it round Price, to play it for David Johnson. Stopped by Clements, but it's not away yet. Rush! Scored goals all season, 22 of them, puts the seal on it for Liverpool in extra time, and now there's no coming back for Tottenham. He played the ball unselfishly there towards Johnson and was there waiting for the return, which eventually came past Ray Clements, and that's the end for Spurs. 3-1 the score. Will stay again with Liverpool. We're playing time added on. What a cruel afternoon for Spurs and their fans. Archibald, Villa, having fought for so long that it was going to be another day of glory for them. appearance at Wembley. No wonder he's being congratulated by Phil Thompson. And then Ian Rush, right at the end, having set the scene on it all for Liverpool. But it's Ronnie Whelan's day, and look at that, it's beautiful. Ray Clements with his old teammates, and all credit to David Johnson and Sammy Lee, remembering Ray Clements, an old chum, in his moment of misery, going across to saying, well, tough luck. And Ray Clements having a word with the man who succeeded him at Anfield, Bruce Grobbelaar. Here, the tradition in the Football League Cup final is that the losers go up first, Tottenham Hotspur, who for so long today must have felt, in spite of the fact that they were hanging on, and sometimes, well, hardly they must have known how they were doing it. In the end, it all went wrong. And it's medals instead of cups. Liverpool chairman John Smith with a word for Steve Perriman. Up those familiar steps to get today not one trophy, but two. The Football League Cup and the new Football League Milk Cup. To be received by the Liverpool captain and the former Spurs junior, Graham Souness. Getting it from Sir Matt Busby. That's the old Football League Cup. Thompson it is, who lost his place and lost the captaincy, who picks up the Milk Cup from Sir Stephen Roberts of the National Dairy Council. Bruce Grobbelaar looking for relatives and finding them, David Johnson, Kenny Dalglish, who certainly made the second goal. Well, the man of the moment, Ronnie Whelan, going down. It's always a place for winners. And they thought they were going to be winners, but now it's a lap of honour by Spurs.